Hey guys, you Burger Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Olympic Marseille career. Where the last time off. Rennes in the league 2-0, and I beat Montpellier 4-1. Yes, Montpellier became the first team to score a league goal against me. And the first team to score a goal against me in a game I played. But I left the last episode on a cliffhanger. Whoops. I wasn't meant to go on to the result. I left the cliffhanger that you saw at the start of the simulation of the game against Sampdoria. You can see the result. A 1-0 win. And Sampdoria were... they were reduced to 10 men. Right at the end of the first half, in the 43rd minute, one of their defenders picked up a second yellow card and was shifted to the shower, to an early shower. And the only goal of the game came in the 73rd minute from the penalty spot. As substitute Hakan Çalhanoğlu, who scored, sending me through to the knockout stages of the Europa League. But unfortunately, that result did mean that Sampdoria were eliminated. I kind of feel bad considering that I do know there is a somewhat of a close friendship between the two teams in real life. Apparently, all I know is that they sometimes share fans or something like that. I don't know what the situation is, but it would appear the two teams don't get along very well. Unfortunately, that's not gonna be something they want to bring up. The fact that unfortunately, that's just the risk that was probably gonna. I mean, if that was a... Either way, no matter what, one of us was probably going out. Unless Krasnodar failed to win their match. But I think they won 3-1 or maybe 4-1. They had a comfortable victory anyway. My victory just meant that I go through top of the group. Krasnodar go through in second place. He's unfortunately finish on 10 points. I think Sampdoria were left on 7. No way. Olympic Marseille's lineup. Yeah, I think they were left on 7. I could be wrong. I'll have to double check that. And he's met it with his that is from the realms of footballing miracles. It's a brilliant clearance from the line. The an out and out one. His instincts were fantastic. 73rd minute goal from the penalty spot. Comes in now. A red card. Well, there's a quick throw. And all of a sudden, Sampdoria, who were looking very lightly up into that point. I mean, only a loss could have... Well, I think a draw might have stopped them from going through as well. Like I said, Krasnodar would have taken my spot if I hadn't picked up the 3 points as well.
Here's a chance to attack. Lost his man.
A draw would have probably been good enough for me, but that might have... I think that would have left Sampdoria high and dry.
Oh, what a moment that would have been for the players.
Anyway, what's done is done. Into the the focus now is on the two who matches in this episode. The League Cup match I've already started with 22 minutes in. And the final game before the January transfer window opens, which is a league game. So this is going to be the last chance for the
Jean-Michel Lesage,
for the second team to show me what they can accomplish. They've definitely improved.
Here's the shot. Oh, saved by the goalkeeper at full stretch.
I didn't think that this, purely from the first few games I played with this team, I never thought this team would get through to the knockout stage of the Europa League. Now, in the end, it was a first team player's goal who got us through. But mostly the work was done by the second team. You know, gotta give him credit for that. Running with Diaby and Sar in midfield.
Chance to cross it.
Hold Diaby at center defense in mid for this game. And
it's an own goal.
Hey! What a sneaky goal that is! And as I was saying, Sar is on the wings. Is that an own goal or I don't know. I think that I'm gonna say that's an own goal on the keeper's part. Yeah. Mervili was really forced into his own net.
Bad enough.
Not sure how that was not given as a foul, but
the player in question.
It's a goal. The referee, he saw nothing wrong with the pressure I was putting on the keeper, which caused the own goal. It's 1-0. Excuse me.
Well, we've got a free kick here. Referee points for it.
Real way to break the deadlock.
Corner out of that. A bit lucky. It was deflected.
This second team seems to specialize. He's in 1-0 over threes. They've only scored one goal once. So hopefully that this can be a second time offense. Yes, it is. I don't know why I said off. Hence me. Yeah, I was talking about my offense. Dung, who right on the stroke of half time, him doubles the lead, and that should see me through to the semi-final of this competition. The fact that I've only conceded one goal in games I've played so far for this career mode would mean this team would have to not only score twice against me. He doing something no other team has done. He'd have to at least match Montpellier's one goal against me, and then do one better. That would just be to try and get to the extra time and maybe a penalty shootout. They'd have to score three at the moment to get into the lead.
There goes the whistle for half time.
There's the halftime whistle. We can check up on the other. Huh? The hell? Okay, it definitely told me this was the quarterfinal. How is this the quarterfinal? Maybe this is the last 16? Did I make a mistake?
So far, Marseille have played well. They got themselves in front. They lead.
I could have sworn it said quarterfinal. Well, obviously, this is not the quarterfinal. Well, because there's way too many teams left. I'd say this is the last 16, and I'm playing to get into the quarterfinals.
Well, it wasn't.
As us Kempos misses, I just had to take a drink of water because I can almost hear the.
It did make it difficult.
Something in my throat. Okay, sorry about that.
So, Alan, what about the first?
No, to my subscribers who might think about starting up their own YouTube channel. Oh, always have Warhand or some beverage, because all this talking will dry out your throat really quick.
Just off the mark.
Well, from that distance, I thought he might have tucked it away, but well, maybe next time.
Hey, it's much better doing this day to day than pre-recording. I mean, unless you do videos yourself, you don't really know. I mean, the amount of talking going into pre-recording things when they were done a while back. Heck, and they'll have to be done again, because hopefully in September I'll be going back to college. Hopefully, anyway.
Cross coming in. No cross, good block.
That's the plan. That plan is yet to bear her fruit, though. So we'll have to wait and see where that goes.
Throw. On EA Sports very soon, the Ligue 1 fixture. Marseille will be facing Bordeaux away from home.
Yeah, both sides have had plenty to offer this season, so this one should be a good time.
We've got an injury.
Why is no one going to it?
Called a halt.
Oh, is that why? Because the guy landed and hurt himself?
As instructed, really giving it back to the opposition, and on we go. That, for sure, is a goal kick.
That's going to be a goal kick. It's the best way to give the ball back to your opponent. Kick it as far into their half as possible if it's anywhere near your goal.
Well, that is a cheap piece of play to give the ball away like that. That's a useful ball in. Well, they've wasted that crossing position, haven't they? Easily cleared. That's another turnover here.
Oof! I was lucky I got that away in time. Muscled off the ball. Oh, but he's giving it straight to Sar! Oh! Brutal. That might be Sar's last. I mean, this might be Sar's last Marseille game. Good. It's his first. It's the first time I'm using him. Him in this team.
Measure of Marseille really.
He asked for the opportunity, so I gave it to him. But the fact that I'm not using him doesn't exactly give his hopes of staying here through the January transfer window.
Now it's 5 minutes.
Much
to
life.
Shoots!
Mastier! Oh my god! History has been made once again. The second team has scored 3 goals in a game. Granted, it's against the second league. It's a second division team. But still. It's quite a goal, to be honest. Mastier? Which I think that might be his first goal for Marseille. I could be wrong. I'm trying to think if that's his first goal since he joined. I mean, I wasn't expecting him to be banging goals left, right, and center. Or that's why. Hey, I got him for a steal 3 mil. Well, obviously, it's his first go in the cup up until now. Well, I haven't played them in the cup. I will have to check that. I think it is, though. I can't remember him scoring any goals in the cup.
Working hard just to see
in the Europa League. Sorry.
Jean-Michel Lesage.
The second division team are dispatched. It's a comfortable 3-0 win. And the own goal was a bad sign early on for this team, wasn't it? I mean, the Dungu goal pretty much sealed it. The Mastier goal was just rubbing it in. None of the Euro games apparently happened. Or, yes, they did. Yeah, that was the last 16. Why did it tell me it was the quarter goddamn final? Where did I see the quarter final?
De La Liga, Troy.
Okay. Liga, yeah, I'm just gonna.
Lorient 3, GFC Ajaccio 3.
Yeah.
GFC Ajaccio 1-5-4 on penalty. Nil. Stade Rennais 1.
There you can see him thanking me for will probably be his one and only Marseille appearance under me before he is moved on in the January transfer window. Risk of losing a player? I offered him a new contract. 6.5 million. Yeah, I'm waiting for him to sign the contract. It's totally up to him. That happens now. I thought I offered him a new contract earlier in the season. He must not have accepted it. There we go. That's sorted. Now, this game against Bordeaux, who are sixth in the league. Wow, they have only played 16 games, the lowest of all the teams. Why have they only played 16 games? It's weird. I will be hoping to extend my lead over PSG that little bit further because they've dropped 2 points since the last time I looked at it. They are now 12 points behind me. I don't know who helped them drop that point, but thank you to whichever team that was. I will look at the results, and I will let you know who it was in the next episode. But, you know, just got that little bit closer. Obviously, I can't win the league title just yet, but hey. The closer and closer I get, the more... Right, hunger or for that success. You know?
Hello, everybody. Martin Tyler is my name. Alan Smith is his name alongside me. And we're hoping to bring you some fine action from this game today. Bordeaux, this is their team. Well, it's pretty fashionable these days, isn't it? The 4-3-3 gives you the three in midfield, which managers like to have an extra solidity.
Yeah, that's right. I'm just looking at the two wide lads up top. They are more central strikers, trying to do a job.
Tohan.
See how they get on.
This is how they love to play on the
break. Ashway.
What a chance now!
Is it Fletcher?
He's got to it.
What was that? Oh my God! If it wasn't so early in the match, I would sub Fletcher off. What was that? I tell him they hit it. He hits it as soft as you're ever going to see a hit.
At the back,
a football hit.
Great understanding across that back line.
Well, they're in a good position here. throw.
Fletcher's not doing himself any favors as of late. He is not playing very well. Oh, he had a very bad episode on Saturday. And now, straight away, he had a really good opportunity to make it 1-0, and he's completely wasted it.
Nothing wrong with that tackle. In fact, it was a terrific effort.
I mean, I am going to be signing Ben Yedder.
Forward by any means. Oh, no.
Without doubt. And here are my thing. Here's a. And my thinking was that he was going to go into improve the offensive capabilities of the second team. He might take Fletcher's place if this keeps up. Well, shut me up. Straight away, this is exactly what happened with Kramer. As soon as I start her talk, even think about boy replacement.
It has cost them, but only a corner could have been.
The only difference being that with Kramer, I had actually signed a possible replacement when he started playing good. And he didn't stop, so maybe this will start a good run for Stephen Fletcher. For his sake, he better hope it does. Because Ben Yedder can go straight into the first team. And I will not hesitate to put him in. In fact, as soon as I sign him, I might just start him in the first league game in January. Just to see how he and Bashawai will pair up. Fletcher? Oh my god, he wasted another great opportunity. So he scores one good opportunity. He could already have a hat-trick. Stephen Fletcher could already have a hat-trick. Now, I'm not saying Ben Yedder might have scored those, but Fletcher should have scored those. Especially if he's hoping to get top goal scorer for this.
To his teammates.
It's Marseille career mode.
Especially today, four draws in a row the home team have managed, but
with the goals Bashawai and Chanelogu are getting, Fletcher is going to keep falling behind if he doesn't get some serious goals. One goal.
Good work by Marseille to get the ball.
Was not good enough.
Clément Chanton. That's out. This will be a throw.
Take the throw.
And there's the throw in. They wasted no time at all. Nkulu.
Kudlu.
It's offside.
And Enkidu is offside. It's really hard not to mix up their names. I'm probably butchering their names anyway, but their names are almost identical with like one or two letter different. When I first saw the two names, I seriously thought they looked the same. Look at that! The only difference is one has D-E-O-U, the other has L-O-U.
Well, we don't have wingers in every game these days.
That is just too similar.
It's a shame because a great winger can make a great game.
Maybe that's why
individual skills in wide
areas. Marseille, he were
I can't remember the time, Martin.
Not too fussed about being practically screwed over by Spurs in terms of the price they got for him.
That's a useful ball in. Oh, in goes the cross. Oh, it's the post.
Oh, Bastard, why you prick? It's the post. Come on. Second time I'm asking. There we go.
Brilliant goal.
I mean, at least he didn't butter his shot.
That was the challenge. In you go.
Not straight to the goalkeeper. Unlike a certain Scottishman I could name. But won't. It seems both my
Nkulu.
His strikers are misses in them today.
He's got that through clever reading of the game, intercepting and getting possession back.
I mean, it's a sad day. Hey, when my second, when Ndungu was more consistent in this episode. But, I mean, for the first goal in the cup game. He decided to practically, he powered the keeper of the opposition into the net. And the second one, he scored himself with pretty much little issue.
Gregory Sertic.
So, yeah.
He's moved in trying to jostle the opponent off his stride. Out of play there. Clément Chanton. Mendy. And he could get away here.
Shawai. Diarra, what's he doing up there? He's scoring goal number three, that's what he's doing. The son of Diarra, what the hell was he doing that far up?
And the way is hit.
I'm still
just flown into the top right
corner. It puzzled by that. I was like, what is Diarra doing up there? I mean, that's the position Çalhanoğlu should be in. And but Çalhanoğlu sitting back. Act like he's the CDM and Diarra was in the position of the CAM. Interesting. I'll take it.
Gregory Sertic. Chanton. There's the ball in. Well, it's a poor cross. Not well hit at all. Dealt with by the defending side. He might be through.
Çalhanoğlu makes it four. The game is wrapped up.
It's a goal which may well have finished.
It's a clean slate.
It's an indication of the golfing class between these two teams.
18 games.
Well, we've got a winger coming.
18 wins, 0 draws, 0 defeats, 1 freaking goal conceded.
Worked. He's been up against a top
domination.
There's nothing come from that side.
Our name is Olympic Marseille.
Diabate. Clément Chanton.
I told you all that there would be no draw in December this time around. And I was spot on. I dominated pretty much all my games in December. Actually, I'd go so far as to say I did dominate all my games in December. Remember, at least the ones that I played. I don't know how the stats of the game against Sampdoria went, but I mean, the fact that they were down to 10 men in at the end of the first half.
That's the way to win the ball back. Well, they look promising there in that wide area, but the defenders don't.
Maybe at some point in a future FIFA, who knows, maybe it'll be in 17, probably won't. But, here's an idea, that they show you the, maybe there's somewhere that you can, like, press a button and it'll show you the match stats. Because when you sim a game, you can't check the match stats, all you can see is whether there was cards, substitutions, and goals.
Marseille, the victors today.
Like, or maybe have this come up at the end of a simulation. Like, say I just simmed this game and we had won 4-0, the game would show me this. I mean, if possible, EA. Yeah, I mean, when you sim a game, it would be nice to know what kind, how did your team got on without you? What the hell? How they handled going into business for themselves, so to speak.
Olympic Marseille with 54 points. In second, Paris Saint-Germain.
That guy jumped up half a freaking bar with 38 or from one session. Brilliant. With 34
points. In fifth, Olympic Lyonnais with 28 points. In sixth, Bordeaux.
PSG. They lost. PSG lost. Climbing the table are Monaco with 26. Oh. Thank you, CN. I know it was CN because that's who they were playing. It showed 12 points. Good. Me the thing. Second bottom, moving down. Hey, yeah, there it is. 2-1. Thank you, CN. 16 points. So, that is like the best Christmas present Marseille could have gotten. In the end 2015. And as we go into the new year, the gap is 15 points. Yeah. Brilliant. And if that doesn't deserve, like, I don't know what does. So, smash the like button. Hit the subscribe button if you're new to the channel so you don't miss any future videos from me. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Oh, wait, and before I go, if you have any suggestions on who I should go for in the transfer window, let me know in the comment section below. So, until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day.